Hello and welcome to WordPress Tutorials. In today's video, I'll show you how to get products from a Shopify site just like this. This is a Shopify website and this is a all shop with no filter selected. So total 77 products are available on this page and I'll show you how to get them all in a CSV including pictures, titles, prices and category. So first of all, we will copy this link and open the Google Chrome browser. We will first open this link in Google Chrome browser and you will also need this extension, which is scrapper.io, webscrapper.io, and you have to install it from Google Chrome Web Store. Open it, More Tools, Extensions, and click on these three bars. Open Web Chrome Store and type webscrapper.io and you will find this extension and you can install it to your browser. This one, which is offered by webscrapper.io, open it and click on Add to Chrome. I already have it, that is why it's saying remove from Chrome. So after you add this to your Chrome browser, then you will be able to see this icon here. Once you have this icon, come to your website again and copy this URL, right click, click on Inspect Element. If you are opening the Inspect Element for the first time, then you might see this on the right side of your page just like this. Then click on these three dots, not for the browser but for the Inspect Element, and click on Drop to Bottom, and then you will be able to see it like this. Click on Web Scrapper, and I already have some sitemaps but you will see this page empty. Click on Create New and create sitemap and paste that URL here and name your sitemap. I'll name it as the website name because I want to remember this for future uses. Create sitemap. Now we have this link as our meta link. So first of all, we will get the single pages, single product links. So click on Add New Selector, click on Single, click on ID and type Single, and the type for this field will be Link because we will get the data from inside all these links. Click on Multiple because we have multiple products on this page. Click on Select and click on each link, and once they are highlighted, scroll down to the bottom and see if all are highlighted. Click on Done Selecting and save it. We do not have any pagination, but if we do, then we will also get the next page link and then we will make it as a parent for the single and for the next page as well. But for now, we only have the single page link. So click on this single and open any product so we can get each and every field. For example, the title, the short description, price, the picture and long description if any. So to add a title, click on Add New. In ID, give it a name such as title or name, leave it as type text, select and choose the title, click on data preview to see if the data is coming, okay, click on save. The parent will be single for this title because it's inside the single page. Click on add new. Now we will get the short description. You can name it anything, leave it as text and choose the parent for short description. Click on data preview. Okay, it's getting. Save. The parent will also be single for this one because it's also on the single page. All these fields will be in within the single page. Click on add new and we will get price. Leave it as text. Choose the price wrap, but I think we got more than that. So let's find out which is the parent for this. Okay, we have this class price item and price item regular. Copy this and type dot. Okay, it's already there. Okay, we can separate this using Excel. Save it. Okay, now we have a weight selection. There are multiple sets of dumbbells, 5 pounds, 10 pounds of pair, 15 pounds pair. So we will also get all these values. There are multiple ways to get this. We can get the HTML of this select HTML tag, but we can also get multiple items, but that will be more complicated because we can manage that in Excel, but that's a lot complicated than this. So we will get it in HTML. So it is weight selection and change the type from text to HTML, select and done. Data preview. Now all the options are within HTML tag. We will separate this in Excel as well. Okay, save selector. Now we have the picture and the long description here. So first of all, let's get the picture. Click on add new image and change the type from text to image and click on select. Choose the iframe, data preview, and we got the link. Save it. Now finally we will get the description, which is in HTML because maybe we have some images or links in it, so we will get this one as HTML as well. So it's the description, change type from text to HTML, click on select and choose the wrapper for the whole HTML. Done selecting, which is return policy. Maybe some other product have the description, but for this one let's just do it and let's open another product if they have a full description. We have this product which have a lot more than just the description. If we scroll down to the description tab, then you can see that shipping and return policy also available, but there are three more tabs: features, specs, accessories option. So we will need all these. Just click the wrapper for the first one, leave the description as it is. Maybe it will get the first tab, which is this one, and then we will get description 2 and choose text HTML and then click on specs, which is tab 2. Click on select and choose the wrapper for this one, and you can see that it's tab 2. Save it. Now click on this again, description 3, text to HTML, select, but first let's choose the third tab, click on select and choose the wrapper. Okay, it's choosing the active tab while we do not need that. We will need tab 3, li, but not li. Let's see what we have for this one, grid item. Copy this thing and add a new feed, description 3, choose HTML, paste that and change from tab 2 to 3, and let's see, we have this one. Okay, save it. Okay, now we have to get the category, but unfortunately that is not available on the front page. So for that we will right click and click on view page source, which I already did here, and then we will search for category. Then you can see that it's in JSON format here. So first we will get the main tag of this JavaScript, and then we will get this value by JSON. So let me show you how it can be done. First let's see what is the parent for this JavaScript, and if it have a class, which it does, copy, the analytics is the class for the script. Come here, click on add new selector and type category. Choose type from text to HTML, because script is in HTML, it's not visible on the front end. So we will first use that analytics class. Click on data preview, where you can see that all that data is available here. Now we will use the regex regular expression here, and the regular expression for category will be just like this. First of all, copy these things, category, double quote, and this up to here. Copy it, paste it here, then type small bracket dot star and then small bracket close and then again double quotes, and let's see if it gets the data. Yes, it is getting the data. We can remove this in Excel after we complete the scrap. So click on save selector and now click on sitemap, start scrapping. Now it will get all the products, all 77 products from this page. I'll pause the video and I'll show you the end result after the scrapping is done. Do not close this this page until all these pages are scrapped. Okay, first the scrapping is done, finished. Then click on sitemap and click on export data as CSV and download the file. Once you download it, open it in a folder or click on this file so you can open it in Excel. Which is the third file, which I guess is not saved yet. Wait for this. Okay, this file, open it. Now you can see that there are 77 rows, and first of all we will separate the options which are in this form. If you double click, then you can see that it's in HTML format, where these are the values. We will extract these values for the option. So first of all, to remove the option value or system from these things, we need to remove this starting point first. So what is our search for this? Right click and copy this and press Ctrl F in Excel and open find and paste it here. Now select from here to there and replace it with asterisk or steric. So it means that whatever is between these two things will be replaced. So if you click on find, then you can see it found results within this first cell. So let's scroll up and replace all with null. Okay, you can see that the values before the thing before values are gone, and we will also remove these null values with nothing. Okay, now we will replace slash options with a comma, because between these values we need a comma. So we will copy this, paste it here and replace it with comma. Replace all, but first select this column, replace all, and done. Now check other options and you can see comma replaced with all these tags. So now before removing the line breaks, first of all we will save the file as CSV. Click on save as and choose your destination. I already built a folder for this in my XAMPP htdocs scrapping and the site name Hoist Fitness and data. Okay, I'll close this file and reopen it from that location. So it's formatted again, Hoist Fitness data. Okay, now we will remove line breaks from these, so all these things will be line up in one single line. So select this column and click on in find and replace. In replace with, leave it empty, and in the find section click press Ctrl plus enter, so it's one line. Now click on find next, and there are a lot of one lines, so we will click on replace all to remove the line breaks. So there is no line break now. Now we will remove the spaces as well, so click on find and press backspace and then one space, and then click here and click on replace all. But maybe there will be some other spaces also removed, so we will replace two spaces with nothing. Click on replace all, and maybe it will resolve the issue. Now you can see that all these options will be in line. Okay, that's all for this one. Now come to the category, and we have this thing to be removed. Add it here and click on replace all, and now the last thing is copy this, paste it here and select that column and replace all. Now save the file and let's see when we close it and open it again from the folder. Now you can see the options are also in line and the categories are also separated. The description, description 2, 3, images. You will have to add the HTTP or HTTPS to all these images, otherwise it may not work. But if it works, then it's fine. Some sites do accept these things. So that was all for today's video. I hope you learned something from this. Please give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to our channel so you won't miss our future updates. Thank you.